Lord God. We thank you that you are our fortress, you are our salvation, you are our all in all. And God, in you is found goodness and gentleness and mercy and compassion and grace and forgiveness. And God, the list goes on. Lord, you are famous for many, many things. For Lord, you're the one who laid the foundations of the earth and breathed life into man. God, there is nothing that is impossible for you. And so, God, I'm asking this morning that you would speak. That you would speak into the heart of man. That you would speak into the heart of woman. That you would speak into the heart of old and young alike. For God, you're famous for talking to your people. Each and every one of us. Even before we came to know you fully. God, there's that prevenient grace where you spoke to our soul and our spirit, allowing us, bringing us to the point of realizing we need you and speaking those words, God, forgive me. So, Lord, we praise you for that. And I ask now that you'd speak to your people that are gathered, that are watching from home. God, I pray this in the holy name of Jesus Christ. Amen. You may be seated. And as I was saying, God is famous for all sorts of stuff. I mean, he's the only one that's ever spoken something into existence. He's the only one that has brought about life out of dirt. I mean, think about that. He's the only one. He's famous for doing a lot of things. He's famous for working in the lives of people. When we think of the Bible, we think of how famous he is for working through young David as a little boy shepherd who grows into this man who then slays a giant. Famous. Famous for what he did in David and through David. Famous for what he did in and through Noah. Noah built this giant boat, brought all the animals on board, and hey, we still have animals today, and we're still here because of the lineage that was carried through Noah. God is famous for speaking to people. Moses and the burning bush. He spoke to Moses through a bush that would not be consumed yet was on fire. Pretty amazing stuff. But also often we get caught up in what he's doing in the adults. And like I said, I started with young David. But most people don't realize that when David got called in, right? When he slayed the giant, he was probably 30 or 33 years old. We always think it's this young shepherd boy, but he was more of a young man. But God is famous for using little people, young people, people that we wouldn't really truly be expecting great things from. I mean, we just got through Christmas, right? God used Mary. Probably in her early teens, maybe like 13 years old or so, to bring about the Savior of the world. And she was seen as righteous because she's like, your will be done. I am willing as you have said. And God used a young person. Let's not forget that. God uses other young people. I was looking this up actually during worship because I couldn't remember exactly where it was in Scripture. It's 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel in the 3rd chapter. You don't have to go there. But it's this story of a young boy, Samuel. Samuel's there in the temple. He's being brought up by Eli. And God speaks to Samuel. And God calls him by name, Samuel. And he wakes up and he's like, what? And he goes to Eli. And Eli's like, I didn't call you. And so Samuel goes back to bed, right? He's like, go back to bed. And then God calls Samuel, Samuel. And he gets up and he's like, Eli. What? No, go back to bed. This happens the 3rd time and Eli finally realizes what's going on. He says, Samuel, listen. It's God calling you. Okay, listen to this. The Lord came and stood there calling as at the other times. Samuel, Samuel. Then Samuel said, speak, for your servant is listening. If I could teach the young people anything, you are not too young. You are not too little. I don't care how little you are. Listen, there is a boy that gave his, I always call it a happy meal. He was willing to give his little sack lunch that Jesus might bless it. The little bit that this little young boy had in his willingness that he might bless it and fed probably about 15 plus thousand people. And the Bible will say 5,000 because they only counted the men, the head of the household. Even the littlest ones God will use if you are listening. Remember that. You're not too young. You don't have to just look for the adults to do great things in this world and have God do those great things through you. You can do great things now. And so the youth went to the Follow conference. It's this time to hopefully teach them not just that lesson, but many, many, many more lessons, many more teachings, or maybe just create this amazing environment where they forget about all the distractions, all the dramas, because who knows, there's no teenage drama ever, right? You're right, because we never create drama either, right? But this great environment where the kids can start to forget about that just a little bit, and walls begin to break down, and all of a sudden now they get away from the distractions and they begin to hear God. And it happened, and you guys are going to hear about that, but I want to show you this video clip about that. And this isn't really my area. This is not fair for me. I got to go on the trip, but Tasha and the other youth leaders, they're the ones that pour into these kids year-round and honestly are cultivating and fertilizing and watering and preparing. And then this event helps out all the more. So I'm going to turn things over to her as soon as this video's up, but watch this video, this highlight reel, if you will.
Let's go. One, two, three. I want to go back. I'm not going to lie. That was so much fun. I think, Danella, please remind me. So everybody give Danella a round of applause, if you would, please. And Ryan. Because, one, I don't think that we recognize very often that if we didn't have two folks in the sound booth, service would look a whole lot different than it does, right? And the other thing is, this is different. So they're having to adapt and be flexible. And that's not always easy. When they know if something goes wrong up here, they're like, who did that in the sound booth, right? So, Danella, because I do not remember, is my game next on your order that you have on your slides? If not, can you do that for me? I do. Could I? We're going to go there first. So, I need two volunteers. So, one of the things that we did at Follow, I move around a lot, so I'm sorry for those that are online because I'm going to be all over the place. We played a game. And we did a lot, we played it with boomers and Gen Xers. So, I would like, if I could please, could I get a Gen Xer to come up? I promise that you will get a prize because I'm all about giving prizes. And I need a Gen Zer, or not a Gen Zer, I need a boomer to come up. Could I please have two volunteers? Yeah? You're a Gen Xer. Okay, Aaron's coming up, so I need a boomer. Can I get a boomer, please? Please, 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 please. Oh, can we make it a family affair? Come on, Connie. Connie, 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 Connie. All right. No, I'll just do it this one, I think. Is it better online if we go up here? Okay. Main stage, folks. Almost, crowd almost as big as Follow. What good sports you are. Thank you. I don't know if you guys know, but when I was in youth, Connie was one of my youth leaders. So she has invested in me, and I get to be up here. Isn't that awesome? So cool to see that. All right, so we're going to play a game called Can You Speak Gen Z? So we will put a word up here, and I want you to give me your best guess at what it means. Okay? I'm not going to lie. That'll be funny in a minute, that I did not know some of these. So it's okay if you don't know them, okay? Because every generation has their own words, right? Like for us, cool beans, right? Yeah. Cool beans, right? Groovy, was that one? Maybe? That one? Okay. So we all have our own words, right? Every generation does. All right, so first word, I'm dead. What do you think that means? No hints from the crowd. No hints? All right. Gen Xer.
I'm going to think that it means I'm in trouble.
Okay. I'm in trouble. That seems logical.
It means that I'm not alive.
Much more logical. Okay. All right. All right. Do I have any Gen Zers that would like to tell us what it means before I put it up? Really, really funny. Let's see. Something is extremely funny. So, new vocabulary. You can all use it to relate to a Gen Zer, right? All right. Yeah. Next one. No cap. I think some people in the audience might know what this means. All right, no cap. Don't tell. Look at you looking out for a helpline.
I know, I'm looking for
Journey. Cheater.
Journey talked me into coming up here.
Oh, okay.
I'm hoping that Journey knows this.
Nope. All right, you get to go first this time, Connie.
Take your cat off in the house.
Take your hat off in the house. Okay?
I mean, the sky's the limit.
The sky's the limit. All right, I did give you guys a little bit of a hint to this one, right? I said, no lie, or I'm serious. So no cap means no lie. Yeah, I don't know. Who knew beans were cool either? I don't know. Okay. All right, next one. Simp. Oh, you can hear this crowd over here. Like, my Gen Zers are like, oh. All right, simp. I, didn't know this one.
Yeah, I would say it's short for simple. Easy.
Short for simple. Okay.
I'm with him.
Oh, we agree. Family agrees. All right. It is anything but simple. Okay. What does it mean? Someone who does way too much for someone that they are interested in is simp. Yep. That's what I would think, yeah. Yep, like I'm in, so they like way too invested that they're interested in. Not so simple. Okay. Next one. Living rent free. Oh, this should be a good one. What does that mean? Aaron's like, I got this one. All right. I'm going to alternate.
Living in a house and not paying anything.
Literally living rent free. Okay. It's a fair statement.
Yeah. I would just say someone that's not real smart.
Someone that's not real smart. Okay, so we're getting some out-of-the-box thinking over here. I like that. Right. I like that. You are trying. All right, what is it? When you can't stop thinking about someone or something. I don't see the connection on this one either, but that's, and I'm a youth leader, but if you hear one of your Gen Zers saying that, they're not, like, that's true. You don't have to pay rent to think about them over and over again. Thanks to our principal for letting us in on that logic. All right, last, I think our last one, pull up. Oh, shh, shh, don't tell.
Okay. I mean, yeah, it's a diaper for a toddler.
Well, I think that one might be hyphenated, but okay, a diaper for a toddler, all right.
Pull up your big girl panties.
Ooh, it's getting real. It's getting real this morning. Pull up your big girl panties. All right. Aaron's like, we're going to have to talk after service, Mom. Okay. I mean, sometimes we have to do that. Okay. What does it mean to come over? If you pull up, you come over. So I'm not usually in. I know. So I don't usually hand out participation prizes, but for today I am. So normally I would have a prize bucket. The teens know this, I have a big prize bucket. But I didn't stop at the 227 to get it before I came over here. So you get a Snickers. And you get a Snickers. You're welcome. Give them a round of applause, please. So, at youth, we usually do some sort of a game time where we laugh and have fun, because part of Christian fellowship is doing that. It is about doing life together and having fun. And we played this at, we played a game that was similar to that at Follow. And I watched even that create a connection between a mom and a daughter that they had something to connect on. Even if it was joking around that they suddenly were, like, texting them and saying, hey, I know, no, like, they were putting, like, these in a sentence, right? And I got to see that daughter come and be at church with her mom and to have a conversation using this game. How cool is that? God does not waste anything. And that was one of the things we learned at Follow. God wastes nothing. So I'm going to ask our teens to come up because they're going to share with you. They've all been asked to pick a favorite thing about Follow. It doesn't have to be like a super spiritual thing, just their favorite thing. Because the other thing we do in youth is honesty, right? We're honest. We try to do life together and we try to be honest. We don't want to play church. We don't want it to feel like it's a space where you have to. So their favorite thing could be we went to an iZone. It could literally be the iZone. That's totally fine if that's your favorite thing. God wastes nothing. So we want to share that with you. This is almost all of them. Aren't they amazing? Look at them. Yeah? Right? I'm embarrassing them right now. I might pay for it tonight. We're only missing a few, but this was the majority that went. And they have all, I didn't make anybody come up. So they are coming up of their own accord. They're like, yeah, sort of, kind of, right? Yeah. They're like, wait. So I'm going to grab a different mic. Do I need to turn mine off or no? All right. I'm going to be, no, I'm not. Okay. I was going to say I was going to be nice, but I think that that might take more time. So I want to make sure that you guys all get out on time so that your bellies aren't distracting you. So we're going to start here, my friend Ari. So they're, they're going to give their name because some of those these guys you don't know. And that's cool, right? You get to meet somebody new today. And they're going to share with you their favorite, one, two, their favorite moments at Follow.
I'm Ari. My favorite thing was probably worship. Like, the worship team was really good. And, like, one of my other favorite things is, like, me and Abby felt really included by Autumn and Kira. And we don't usually get that being, like, the two only middle school girls. So.
Thank you, Ari.
Okay, I'm Autumn, and Follow 2023 was awesome. I went in 2019, but Follow 2023 was just deeper. So my favorite part was ice skating, and so Matt fell a lot, but.
No, really, a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But every time he just got back up or someone helped him up, and I just skate circles around him. One time I just stopped and just watched Toby and Tucker help him up after they pushed him down, but they picked him up, helped him up, and it reminded me of how God helps us up and uses what we go through for greater purposes.
Thank you, Autumn.
I'm Kira. My favorite part about Follow, I went in 2019, and it was, I think I said might have said the same thing. It's just being in a room with 5,000 other people our age and seeing them all just as on fire for God as you are. Like, during worship, my brother Truett was a chaperone, and the first night he encouraged all the teens at some point to stop during worship, to stop singing, and to just listen to the other 5,000 teen voices that are singing with you. And so I think most of us took that advice the next day at some point, and it hearing 5,000 other teens sing just as loudly as you are, it makes you feel so not alone and helps you to know that you may not be surrounded by them in your daily life, but they're there, and they're there for you to lean on.
Thanks, Kira.
I'm Isaac. So I was going to say probably the worship was, it was really good. And, yeah, skating, that was fun.
Thanks, Isaac.
All right, I'm Asher. I had two favorite things. The first one was seeing 5,000 teens and young adults all just sing and worship together. That was really fun. And then in Follow 2019, I went, but I don't really, it didn't feel as good as this one. This one, we grew as a youth group. We grew together. We shared lots of feelings together. We were happy together. We cried together, like lots of stuff. It's just, we grew as a youth group and more as a family, too.
My name is Matt McPhee. My favorite was ice skating, worship, and riding bird scooters downtown Cincinnati with all the guys and Pastor Scott.
My name's Asher, and my favorite thing was worship and riding bird scooters with all the guys.
I'm Abby, and my favorite part was obviously the Torn Wells concert and my brother making room for me to go up to the front.
So before Sarah goes, Abby's for real the biggest, no lie, or no cap, the biggest Torn Wells fan I have met. And that's who sang the song Famous For, that when we got to sing that as a worship group. So she was super excited to be able to do that. Go ahead, Sarah.
So my favorite part was just like, well, just the way that God spoke to me in many ways. And I was trying to like come up with it to put it all together, but it was just hard to, because sometimes like just describing in human words just doesn't describe like how God can move and just how his timing is just so perfect. Amen. And so just spending time with everyone and just the way he was able to speak to all of us.
Awesome. Thank you. Any last comments? Crew, before I have you, or unless you want to stand up here the whole time, but you probably want to go back and sit down. Yeah? All right. Go have a seat. Thanks, guys. I forgot my phone. I have my notes in it. Follow, one of the things we did for Follow was every day they had a challenge. And we call that challenge God sightings. So they were challenged with looking throughout the day to see God. Where is God showing up? Is he showing up in worship? Is he showing up in the breakout sessions? Is he showing up, you know, every night we got together, whether it was as a big group or in our rooms, you saw both of those things on the video, to talk about the day and to share. Was it in that moment? Sarah, one of my God sightings, when she shared how God was speaking and putting together things that happened here, putting them all together and then seeing them, like how they fit, like how the puzzle all fit together, and getting that at Follow, for me was a God sighting, right? Seeing that. We prayed specifically, we had a prayer team, so I want to thank those of you that were on that prayer team. We prayed for unity for our group. Because when you spend that long together all day, every day, and you're staying up until like 1 or 2 in the morning, you can get a little irritable, right? They didn't. They were amazing. I think Asher said it best. You know, we grew as a group and as a team. I owe big thank yous, and Pastor Scott mentioned it already, but to him too, to our youth staff that went and our volunteers. The teens literally could not go unless I had volunteers that were willing to go with them and for them to give up time with their families and to focus. So the thing about going is they're focused on these guys. They're not focused on what they want to do. They're not focused on the fact that they're tired, that we had to wait for an hour for our food lots of times because there's a gajillion teenagers in downtown Cincinnati in the restaurant. You know what I mean? Like there were a lot of times that we all could have been, could have lost our focus, and we didn't. And so I appreciate that because they're super supportive to me as a youth leader, but more importantly to the teens that went. So big thank you to them as well. Yeah, let's clap. Thanks, Czar. You're right. They deserve it. They deserve hooting and hollering too. We did have a teen that accepted Christ while we were at Follow. So thank you. Lots of screaming for that. Right? Party in heaven. It's awesome. We're going to sing a song at the end that says, Hell Lost Another One. And that is what happened at Follow for not just this teen, but for a lot of others as well. We had some teens that got a call from God, that God spoke to them and said, I'm going to call you in a space that maybe you're not comfortable with. I'm going to call you in a space that you don't know where you're going to go, but I'm calling you there. And so pray for those two teens, because not every teen, they asked you to get down on your knees. Not every teen did that. There were two in our group that did that, which again, a space where you don't have to follow and do what everybody else is doing, but do what God has called you to do. And one last thank you to all of you. We couldn't have gone if we would not have had your support and your prayers. Your financial donations allowed for no teen to have to worry about paying for anything. The food was covered, the hotel was covered, the conference was covered. The Hays allow us to use that beautiful 15-passenger van. We wouldn't be able to go without that, right? That was all covered. The only thing that they had to bring was money for spending, which, to be honest, they didn't really have a lot of time to do that either because we were always busy doing other stuff. So it created like that level playing field where everybody got to go. Yes, thank you. I wanted to talk a little bit about how God uses people. So we don't have our normal crowd in here, but I think if I were to ask this question, I would probably get more hands. But I want you to raise your hand if you were between the ages of 15 and 25 in the years between the years 1960 and 1980. Can you raise your hand? If you were between the ages of 15 and 25 between 1960 and 1980. A lot of adults in this space, right? Do you know what happened in that time frame? Anybody? The Jesus Revolution happened during that time frame. Do you know that by 1977, there were over 2 million new believers in Christ? Mostly between the ages of 15 and 25. Powerful movement. It was a movement that has influenced preaching, Billy Graham. I see lots of nods. Most people know Billy Graham, right? He was a part of that movement. That's why we know Billy Graham, actually. That's why we know his name. Yeah. Contemporary Christian music. Guess where it has its roots? The Jesus movement. The name Jesus Freak also comes from the Jesus movement because they were telling them that it to be negative. And they were like, heck no, I'm going to wear that as a badge of honor, right? I'm a Jesus freak, right? It has affected this church because a lot of you that lived through that movement are here and have impacted this church. Those young people are now people that are sitting in this congregation, and you are the church. One of the things that stuck out to me was Jim Lowe, who, if you know a lot of people in the Wesleyan Church, you'll know who Jim Lowe is. If not, Google him, but he does a lot of missionary work, a lot of work in the Wesleyan Church, and a lot of work with young people. But he said something at Follow that really stuck with me. He told the teens and young adults, because they did have young adults there as well, he said, "You are not the future of the church." I was like, okay. He said, "You are the church." And I think sometimes we put ourselves and young people in a box to say, not your time yet. It'll come, but it's not your time yet. Their time is now. Your time, sitting back there, I don't care what your age is, your time is now for such a time as this. You are here for a reason. You are here for movement. You are here to make a difference. You are here to be a light. The theme of Follow this year was empowered. So I Googled it because I love Google. If anybody knows me, like I have a Google phone, I love Google. If I have a question, I'm Googling it. So the definition of empowered is to give someone the authority or power to do something, to make someone stronger and more confident, especially in controlling their life and claiming their rights. Isn't that what Jesus did for us? He died on a cross, and he rose again. I love this section over here. They're like my amen section. They're like, yep, yeah. So let's follow that. Kids, by the way, saying that, just saying, right? He died on a cross and rose again so that we could have authority. We could have a spirit of boldness. We could have confidence in who we are, claiming our rights as a child of God. That, my friends, is something to celebrate. And it's an identity that I want to walk in. So, because we've given you lots of challenges this service, we're going to give you one more. We are going to invite you to do that now in worship. We're going to play two songs that we, actually as a youth group, prior to Follow, we didn't have in our worship playlist. Oh, three songs. We've got three songs. Okay. That we did not have in our worship playlist. One is called Thank God, and the other is called Praise. These might require movement, okay? I mean, it's going to feel weird. It's okay. Clap, all right? You saw some of the worship videos up there, and if you've ever read about David, that man was moving when he was praising, okay? We're going to invite you to do that. We want to praise God for what he's done for us. We want to recognize that. He did something for us that we could never do for ourselves. And I think sometimes we get so used to it that it loses, I think it loses some of the shine to us sometimes because we kind of get so used to it, right? But I think doing things like Follow and changing things up, even today, though it might be uncomfortable, can kind of give us a different perspective. And I'm hoping that you'll walk away today with just a little bit of a different perspective.
our last challenge, because I usually leave the youth with a challenge, like I did at Follow, right, God Sightings, is that you will worship, you will really take the opportunity to worship and not be afraid about what the person next to you or behind you is thinking, even if it's different from what you normally do. Because to be honest, what they think doesn't matter. It just doesn't. No cap. That's right. Amen. No cap. All right. So we are going to turn down some lights because at youth we do it with the lights down. It might be a little bit louder than normal. This is not as loud as we have it at youth. So we're giving you a little bit there, right? I want to encourage the teens. Some of them talked about wanting to maybe move up front a little bit. If you want to join them, please do. Kids, if you want to come up and hang out with the teens and clap and jump, you can do that as well. But I would encourage you to take time to worship God. Just have a moment with you and him in this space.
Two, three, four.
Walking through the valley, yeah. No, I got
Heavenly Father, Lord God, how can we not praise you? For God, you are the one who pours out your Spirit where it is welcomed, where we have an open heart to receive. God, I think of this morning, I think of this, God, I just think of everything that has been spoken, not just about the young, but also about the old. God, that where our hearts are open, you will pour out your Spirit. It says in the book of Joel, and afterwards, I will pour out my Spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will see visions. Lord, you have something for each and every one of us. God, you have placed a calling on each and every person here. And so, God, may we receive it. May we welcome it, because the same Spirit that rose Christ Jesus from the grave is pouring out and anointing upon each and every individual who welcomes it, because you are calling us to greater things, and you will empower us to do those greater things for your glory and for your purpose and for our betterment. And so, God, would you do that now, I pray? Would you anoint every person that is welcoming your Spirit from the top of their heads to the soles of their feet to walk in the power and the fullness of God's glory, that as we scatter, as we leave this place, we will have a spirit of boldness and courage like never before to praise you and to declare your glory to any and all who will listen. And God, to you be the glory always as our Savior, the Savior whose name is Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. May you all have a great week in the Lord. God bless.